18101. In this video, we will be discussing the economic and fundamentals moving the gold from 10 till 14 August. So let's begin. Do keep in mind that this is the part 2 of the video. This is the part 2 and the part 1. Link would be in the description and screen or in the iCard above. To watch that, as that would be focusing on the technical perspective, and this is the fundamental. Now coming on the fundamentals, first we will be discussing about the bearish fundamentals moving the market. Is that on Friday we have a positive farm payrolls and the unemployment data were positive, which means we have received a decrease in unemployment and an increase in non-farm payroll, due to which we have seen a sale off in the market for the gold from some around 2074 closing price, some around 2035, and the low of that day was 2015. Since we have seen a huge sale off, and usually the non-farm pay economic and fundamental reason why which we have seen and sale off some around here. Now moreover, usually the non-farm payroll and unemployment rate continue its impact on the market for around on Monday and on Tuesday. This due to which we can expect a depreciation in the prices for the gold on Monday and Tuesday. Moreover, we have seen that the many companies which were assuring to make the vaccine for COVID-19 are still committed that they can provide the vaccine till the end of 2020, which is in good news for the US dollar, however, which is in bearish news for the gold. Do keep that in mind. They are just stating that these companies are just stating that they can provide, however, they haven't make an effective vaccine yet. Thus, this suggests that they are just guessing, or that's in wild guess, which they are telling us that they can make a vaccine till the end of the year. Moreover, we have seen that the US and China tensions are been increasing, and which I will discuss in further part of the video. However, if we see any fundamental news decreasing the tension between US and China or escalating the tension, this would be a very bearish signal for the gold, as the uncertainty due to which has been increased. Thus, the fundamentals moving the market for the gold has been explained. The bearish fundamentals. Now coming on the bullish. The bullish fundamentals moving the market would be the Fed has made it clear that its policy would be accommodating for some times, giving the fixed income a stronger anchor and a negative real yield, while like a more significant driver for the gold. Still, even the anchor spilled on Friday as the stronger dollar hurt the prices for the moreover gold. The United States sets a record for the COVID-19 or the coronavirus, as the cases on Saturday with more than 5 million people now infected according to their data, as the country's top infectious disease official offered hope earlier this week that an effective vaccine might be available till the end of the year. However, they are just claiming that. Moreover, we have seen a double trouble after failing to reach a deal with US Congress for a fresh round of pandemic relief. President Donald Trump on Saturday signed a series of executive orders aims to support the hard hit the economy had due to the COVID. Moreover, the uncertainty over the fresh stimulus measures coincides with the renewed deterioration in the ties between Washington and Beijing. Last week, the Trump unveiled sweeping bans on Chinese tech firms such as TikTok and Tencent, escalating a high stake concentration over the future of global tech industry. Moreover, we have seen a weakness in the dollar, or the dollar losing its prices as the sentiment has turned against the greenback due to the combination of rising US coronavirus infections, a steady decline in the treasury yield, and a lack of consensus in Washington over additional stimulus packages. Analysts say that the dollar will continue its fall, particularly against the euro, the yen, and Swiss francs, as expected for a V-shaped recovery from the pandemic fades. Moreover, the chief market strategist at CMC Market in Sydney said that I see further dollar weakness. Optimism for a economic recovery is not backed up by the data, and the safe havens are very high, but the stocks are also high, which does not make sense. The party has to end up at some point, either by the gold or by the safe haven or either by the stocks. Moreover, China, the first country to be struck by the pandemic, is set to release a raft of economic data this week, and the investors would be looking for that. Meanwhile, the senior US and Chinese officials will be reviewing the implementation of their phase one trade deal during a video conference on Saturday. Now, concluding that we have seen that the Fed has said that its policies will support the fixed income narrative, and moreover, they present a perspective that they would be encouraging the negative bond yield, due to which we can see uncertainty in and form for dollar losing its value. Thus, dollar being inversely proportioned to gold or the safe haven, we can see a steady rise in the prices for the gold. Moreover, we have seen that the US has set a record for the COVID-19, crossing its milestone of 5 million, which means again creating uncertainty in the market. We can see that the US Congress has not been agreed to relieve the new stimulus packages, and they have challenged that if this act has been implemented and the packages are released, that can be challenged in the court. Moreover, we have seen a deterioration in the relationship between the US and China over the ban of big Chinese tech companies such as TikTok and the Tencent games, creating uncertainty in the market. Moreover, we have seen a negative treasury yield. We have seen that the market analyst at CMC Market Chief Analyst has said that he is expecting a decrease in the value of the gold. Moreover, we have seen that the investors were hoping for a V-shaped recovery. However, this isn't very uncertain that we attain a V-shaped recovery. However, we can attain a W-shaped recovery, which means we can first see a decline, which we have seen in here, then we have seen in rise. Now what we can see is again decline in the market due to the second wave of the coronavirus, and then again we can see that the market for the US can carry its move higher highs and the market for the gold can carry its move lower high. But however, this isn't the case. For this higher high move, first we have to go through this lower low move in the market for the in the US market. Moreover, we have seen that the investors were optimistic. However, their optimism has been fading away. Moreover, we have seen that the US and China would be talking on the phase one of the for the phase one trade deal. Now we can also highlight that there have only been approx 90 days left for the presidential election, and due to this fact we can expect that the prices for the gold can rise, as this can create uncertainty. And we can see that the Trump, due to the current pandemic, can take the advantage, the President Trump can take the advantage of this pandemic in order to extend its presidential tenure, which means uncertainty and violence in the US, creating uncertainty in the market again. Thus, these were the bullish reasons which you should keep in mind for trading on the gold. Now coming to the second part of the video, in this part we will be discussing how to trade the economic events and what would be their impact of their release for the gold from 10 till 14 August. So on Monday and on Tuesday we do not have any crucial economic event. However, on Wednesday we have two events. On Wed 12th August we have two events. The first event is the CPI. The forecast value for the CPI is 0.3. If we get numbers greater than 0.3, such as 0.4 or 0.5, which would be a sale signal for the gold. However, if we get numbers less than 0.3, such as 0.2 or 0.1, which would be a buy signal for the gold. Why traders care about it is due to the fact that the consumer price accounts for a majority of the overall inflation, and inflation is an important for the currency valuation, because rising price leads to the central bank to raise interest rate out of the respect for their inflation containment mandate. Now the second economic event is the core CPI. The forecast value is 0.2. If we get greater numbers than 0.2, such as 0.3 or 0.4, which would be a sale signal for the gold. However, if we get numbers less than 0.2, more preferable in negative, such as negative 0.1, that would be a buy signal for the gold. Moreover, why traders care about it, as the consumer has its provide the insane about the inflation in the country. Moreover, moving on Thursday, we do not have any economic event. However, on Friday, 14 August, we have core retail sales. Core retail sales, the forecast value is some around 7.2. If we get greatest numbers than 7.2, that would be a sale position for the gold. However, if we get numbers less than 7.2, that would be a buy signal for the gold. Moreover, why traders care about it, as the automobile sales accounts for about 20% of the retail sales, but they tend to be very volatile and distort the underlying trend. The core data is therefore thought to be a better gauge of spending trends, which means it analyzes the spending trends in an economy. Moving on, we have the retail sales. The previous one was the core retail. Now we have an retail sales. The forecast value is the same. If we get numbers greater than 7.2, a sale signal. If we get numbers less than 7.2, a buy signal. Moreover, it's a primary cause of the consumer spending, which accounts for the majority of the overall economic event. Now, if you like the video and if you are new to the channel, so do consider subscribing, as I post weekly analysis on gold and crude oil and the daily forecast too. So if you are new to the channel, so do consider subscribing, and if you like the video, do like, share and comment below. Thanks for watching.